here. Scooter.
Yeah.
That steamboat we took.
Oh, Lord. Could have been.
It's like two tour.
AC. Ice cream. Ice cream.
Yo te lo doy para que no haya cola, para que no pares partido. Wait. Porque para ir a casa. Sí.
What round thing?
Big round thing. Dancing.
Oh, yeah.
So almost got the same thing at Jason Kelly. Right up there.
Oh, here.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, you can move to your last song, you know?
This guy going to play Style of the Series.
So is the one one is working until now. Who's working until now? It's only you.
This is a Vietnamese owner.
And
a Vietnamese manager.
What that, honey? I bet it's cash only.
Maybe. Does he have his swimming
pool? Oh, shrimp. I gotta get my wife something Cajun here.
Cajun?
Check one two. Open the 5-8 doors now. I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Huh?
Check 1-2. That'll work.
Our car can be booted.
Come get some muffalata.
A lot of bread.
YouTuber.
Big YouTuber.
$10.
I said I'm walking towards you, but if you hang up the phone,
no. You go. I pass.
Where's your penny?
I'm going in, going there.
In the park. Yeah, how we get in there.
Thank you.
Ready?
Where are you going, Tony?
The church.
Good morning.
Have you been inside the church?
No, I didn't go inside that church.
Let's go. Let's go inside.
No, we're not going there. It's
not. We're going inside the church. So you can come with us tomorrow morning. Mary's coming.
Who?
Mary.
That's 5 p.m.
5 p.m.?
Let's go. No food or drink. It's a tour. Tour is free. It's free.
Right to the altar.
Thank you. proximity.
The paint job, and it's different wherever you go.
Thank you.
You know, don't listen to a Filipino.
Gosh, you mean bad. Should kick you.
They're all different. Like gray is gray.
A boat.
I see it.
Miss a boat.
There goes Mary Rose. They had Cajun food there.
Where?
Which has it?
Hey, we're in New Orleans, so we'll talk to you later.
Well, that's the kind I would like, not the different things that she picks out. I like that one too. Catch up to the other tour. Let's go. It is.
Godzilla.
Thank you.
Humpty Dumpty on the wall. Michael.
You want your picture with Michael Jackson?
Or King Kong? I don't sit on it.
No. Really? Happy Mardi Gras!
Only my wife, Tony.
Yes, so with them, we beg for forgiveness rather than ask for permission. So far, it has not been a problem. You always make sure to keep a super visual thing so that it's a little more defensible. And then beyond that, we fall back on satire protections. And in fact, the crews are nonprofits. So I'm sure if somebody wanted to do it,
Let's get that reset. You want that light to be?
Otherwise, sometimes I actually have to stand on this layer on the square here, and then you're kind of offset from it enough that it usually still leaves it relatively stable. And that way you can usually still read it pretty well. Alright. Happy Mardi Gras!
Excuse me?
Alright, and then everybody's seen the next part of the year. You're not going to take out afterwards. So you can come back through here, and then there's like a couple of stuff to see. And you go to a level of the United States, you're going to spend more time here afterwards. And explore more and take more photos. Yes, ma'am, you're right on behind. That is the head that is going to be used for the fireplace on the front of that fireplace. And like I was saying, those folks will want to be the right there. Concept art is at 100%. But we'll see. So, during this portion of the tour, I try to focus us in a little bit on the parades themselves, give people a little bit of insight into what that's like. After months of telling people what I think they should know, I think I've enjoyed opening it up to questions, seeing if anyone has questions about Mardi Gras, or New Orleans, or parades, or anything. Nothing, as long as it's appropriate, nothing is off the table. So if anyone has a question they'd like to lay on me at this point, go for it. I don't put you on the spot, so no one has something handy in the room. You look like you have a question.
What's been your favorite theme in recent years, or ever?
I don't remember ever, honestly, because I grew up here, and then I went away for school and then came back. But this year, I got to see a lot of parades, and my favorite parade is always Orpheus. Their theme is almost just an excuse. Like, their theme is very non-literal. So Orpheus's theme this year was Dark Dickens and Childhood, which what that really, how that was interpreted is every club was based on, like, a moral of a story from, like, a Grimm's fairy tale thing. So think, like, be careful what you wish for, good things come to those who wait. Kind of those types of tropes or morals were the name of each club, which really, rather than a literal theme, was more of a kind of excuse for a gothic, dark fairy tale aesthetic throughout the whole thing. So the whole parade had kind of a dust fairy, but like Grimm's fairy tale kind of vibe. And it was just really cool. Orpheus is always beautiful, they cover all their clothes from here. They were powers, you stay in a lot of this drawing, having a huge part of the religion, which is that. And you know, you were probably as you were. Any other questions? For 60, 70 years, but we don't do Rex anymore. But we do the most famous ones, pretty much. At the risk of sounding like, no big deal, but we do. Honestly, that comes to mind for me, the biggest thing I can ever see is those logs in terms of sheer size. Because those are freestanding, they don't want to build big marble cuts. Those are very, very big now. We have replaced riders in Bacchus this year. Those guys probably spent on average about 11 hours on their floats. Some of them might have spent less, and some of them definitely spent more. Keep in mind, if you're on the first float, you get off a lot faster than the guy on the last float, because those parades are miles long, multiple miles. So I'm sure someone who's too classy to say it out loud, but someone is wondering the million-dollar question, where do I pee? Well, if you've been to the French Quarter, you might think we just pee wherever we want, but at a Mardi Gras parade, things are a little classier. You use the bathroom on the float. So all of the floats that we build at Kern Studios are going to have a bathroom on it, at least one. So if you look right here at this, actually it's easier to see up here. If you look at this yellow float up at the top with the golden columns, you see where there's a door open on that top little platform? That door goes into that square little room, and it is a porta-potty bathroom outhouse kind of thing. It ain't the Ritz-Carlton. There's no bidet or anything. But there is at least a something better than a hole at the bottom of the floor. Now, I will say not every parade has a bathroom because we don't decorate all the parades. So again, the parade that he's in isn't all... Y'all just had a bucket, right? That's what you told me before.
Depending on what float you're on. Mine had a bucket last year.
So this is an all-male parade that we don't decorate. So they've got a different standard. I mean, we've got a lot. We got a nice mixed gender group here. So I'm sure most of the boys here can say, yeah, I would pee in a bucket if I have to. Most of the ladies are probably like, shoot me now, please. So there's going to be some variation, but the floats, the parades we work with, we do make sure everyone's got bathrooms. I like to point out this prop because I love a good Western, and I also think it's got kind of a cool story as to how it came to be. So you probably recognize this guy as Clint Eastwood, the man with no name from the famous spaghetti Westerns. But if you are looking at him and you're wondering why Clint Eastwood is standing like he's a male model or something, he's really working. That is because he used to be a different prop that is most famous for standing that way. Second most famous for being butt naked, and he's in Florence, Italy. David, yep, this was Michelangelo's David in a previous life, the famous statue that you see the statue, the most famous naked man in the world, until I get my way. All right. So we had a Western-themed parade, and David was hanging out, and we decided to improve upon Michelangelo's work, put some pants on David, classic going up a bit. So just like the Sherlock Holmes you saw at the beginning, the clothes really can be in the man sometimes. Most of the props we've seen along this tour weren't in parades this year, 2023, but this yellow head with the pink weird nose thing, that actually was in a parade this year. So that was in the crew of Orpheus, my favorite parade this year. We are coming up on the last stop of the tour, which is going to be Pixie, our sculpting robot. Unfortunately, unlike us, she gets the weekends off, so you won't get to see her in action, but you will get to kind of get a sense of what she looks like, and we do have a video that plays on a loop in the last window, so you can see her actually sculpting a bit. But if you look in these windows here on your right, you'll see Pixie on her metal track towards the kind of middle back portion of the room. She looks kind of like a scorpion tail when she's just posted up there. So essentially, she's a drill bit on a highly programmable, maneuverable robot arm. And we can build 3D models. So the workflow for the robot, there are two folks that run the robot, and they build 3D models on the computer of what we want Pixie to sculpt. And they use those 3D models to engineer Pixie's toolpath. And the toolpath is the program that actually tells her choreography. So the toolpath is what says, go 3 inches to the left, 2 inches down, 4 inches to the right, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And all that stuff does need to be built out by hand by the people running the robot. But once you've built the program, you push start, and she does the rest. She can change her own tools in the middle of a job if she needs to go in for a different type of cut or something more detailed. And essentially, she's a drill bit who's going to just scrape along the surface of the prop. So she doesn't cut. I know that it's kind of how you imagine sculpting something like this. You would imagine cutting it up, right? That's not how the robot does it. It actually stands down, basically. So fortunately, they cleaned the room recently. And sometimes it's chopped a block with styrofoam dust. So the last thing I'll say, and y'all are free to explore as you please, and I'll answer any questions that you might still have lingering, is tell you why we named Pixie Pixie. So the robot is named for the lady, Miss Pixie Nathan, a real woman who used to work with the company a long, long time ago in a galaxy right here in New Orleans. She started as our secretary and then stayed on with the company and girl bossed her way up to the top, where she eventually became the executive vice president of the company and basically ran the place. So when Miss Pixie passed away, we wanted to make sure we paid our respects to her. So we named the robot after her. We put her story into the tours, and we also put Miss Pixie in the mural on the back wall. So if you're on that side, you might have more trouble seeing her, so you might want to come more this way. But she's right in the crook of the robot's arm. She's the Queen of Mardi Gras, so she's in a yellowy white dress, right under the drill bit or in the crook of the arm, a white dress with a big old clamshell collar and a tiara on her head. And that is the real Miss Pixie Nathan. And if you don't trust me, I don't know why you wouldn't, but if for some reason you don't, I don't know who hurt you, I guess. I do have the receipts to prove it. I got a photo of Miss Pixie right over here next to the Superman logo, so you can see that that is her face. They just kind of de-aged her a little bit, like Harrison Ford in the new Indiana Jones movie. But that way Miss Pixie can keep an eye on us in the warehouse, make sure the artists are hitting their deadlines, make sure I'm not skipping her in my tours. She always smites me when I do. She'll come down with some voodoo magic and say, no tips, no compliments, nothing for you, Mac. So I always got to make sure I pay my troll toll to Miss Pixie. But thank you very much for your attention, your time, your questions. That's it for the tour, y'all. My name is Mac. It's been a pleasure. Like I said, you can spend all day in here or until 5:30 in here. So if you can spend that much time without melting, we should trade positions. But to give you the lay of the land, it's a big circle. So if you took a right here, that's going to put you where we entered the warehouse, next to the gift shop. And just make sure you catch where it says more photo ops this way. Make sure you catch that before you leave. There'll be props you won't have seen otherwise. But if anyone has questions, I'll hang out for a couple minutes right here and answer them up for you.
These are going to get us a few different times.